where the rails are. You can look through it. So the paper is so thin you can look through it. When you take a banana unit and you keep it to the light, you can in the middle it is you can't look through it, but in the surrounding you can look.
Because
you can see the light.
Yeah.
How they do it, I don't know.
I've been just discussing this phenomenon with a very nice guy in Seattle, which make Eastern Acoustic Works speakers, which is big for PA systems and that kind of stuff. This way of making the membrane itself, then you get rid of the phenomenon which is called breaking up. For it moves as one unit, and for the higher frequencies it's not starting to wobble about. So that's very interesting actually.
But how Banaya succeeded to get this behavior of a membrane
is better
of such a light weight and such thin paper.
It's amazing.
And also making the voice coils. He learned making voice coils from the guy. He lived in Paris. And he told me one day he went there and he worked there for some time with this man. And he made all the voice coils for Audax. And that was in the older days, in the 60s, I think, something like that. And when I made his voice coils of vellum. Vellum is the, you know, the old way of making a drawing. You make first the drawing on the transparent paper, and then you put it through a machinery and make a print of it.
Yes.
And this transparent paper, you have it in very thick quality. And when you take, by example, the modern material, like say aluminium or the paper, I don't know the name.
And carbon fibers?
By example. He took then the cone of the membrane with the little tube with the coil on it, and then he did this, and they with the other stuff your tock, with his stuff your tack, tack.
Yeah, it's lighter.
Yeah, it is lighter, but the sound is different.
Yeah.
And also he said to me that explained that vellum, to his opinion, was the best material to make the little tube.
For the coil,
everyone who listens to these units of Phi, they all say the same. It is incredible how nice they sound.
Okay.
One of the reasons must be this film.
Yeah, but in this way of thinking and producing and making the speakers, this has to then be the cost of power handling and maximum output things. Because that's also a parameter in my world. How loud can the speaker play, and for how long can it play?
Of course. How long does it stand all this all this violence?
Yes.
Which
so, and the more fragile the construction is, then you have a lower limit on that part.
Yeah, of course.
But again, you get more sound or higher sensitivity, of course, if everything is much more lighter. This should be plain physics, shouldn't it? It's the normal physics law.
Yeah,
this
is normal physics law. Yeah.
More or
with
less.
Exceptions.
But we still have 2 ears, remember?
I learned at school and do my study a lot of physics laws, but afterwards I discovered that many of these laws are more or less true. Totally true. By example, I learned in school liquids, you can't compress liquids.
That's what we have learned, maybe.
I learned that at school. But it is total nonsense when you realize about a black hole in the universe. Yeah. Everything is compressed to nothing. Yeah.
Yes.
So, liquid.
So, yeah.
But the inner parts of my speakers, they are made with a water cutting machine.
Okay, yeah.
So I went to those guys and I was discussing about the pump. There's a plunger pump. And I said to them, you need an expansion vessel eliminating the pressure pulses. They said it is doing the water itself. And then I saw by myself. Yeah, they said water is compressible. Oh, yeah.
school.
Yeah, but I learned in school it is not compressed. Yeah, but they work with about 2,000 atmospheres.
Yes.
And then the 1 liter, when I remember, is reduced to 0.7 liter at 2,000 atmosphere pressure.
So, what happens to the rest of that volume? Does it disappear? Does it
you simply push together the
transfer into heat
the
or what?
How do you call that? Yeah. The molecules, you press them closer together.
Yeah.
But because every material is in a way a little things which move in the space.
Yes.
So, and when you heat it, they go further from each other.
Yes.
They call the, they call this internal. How do you call it? Yeah, in English. Oh, okay. It has to do with energy. You have to put energy in it to heat it. But what you do is you expand it.
Yeah,
I got you. Yeah, and this is quite interesting stuff. And how can we transform? How can we transform this idea into a beautiful sound then?
Yeah.
Yeah. Because these days in music production, everybody is using compressors to reduce the dynamics. You know, to get maximum level, and soon everything sounds like shit. If you ask me.
Shit.
Yeah. Because
a lot of modern loudspeakers sound like shit, in my opinion.
Totally.
A lot of modern audio equipment, it says something about our level of how do you call it? Our level of culture.
Yeah.
Because we had never, there was not a time everyone had so much money to spend. And at the same moment, we produce enormous amounts of shit, even toys for children.
Yes, which are ridiculous expensive.
But when the child touches the toy he gets, it is damaged, or it is nothing, or it is.
Yeah.
And then the guy comes to heaven, and the Lord asks him, "What did you do in your life?" "Yes, I made toys for children." But and then the Lord asks him, "Was it good stuff?" No, it was shit. So you were making your whole life shit for children. And that must learn children something about quality of life.
Shame. I got you. Nice one.
Terrible.
Okay.
Terrible.
We'll wrap it up.
Yeah,